first one with the notes. I'm Lucas. I work for Jive, so I just took this opportunity to start talking more. So do that. So we can go ahead and fire it off. First, I'd like to start by letting you know this whole presentation is filled with images that I don't own, and I thought no better way to drive that home than to show you every Super Bowl logo in the history of So, if you've ever been curious, you can find that in Google Image Search, where you can find my entire presentation. Welcome to Splitting the Pyramid. As I said, I'm Luke Leverett. I wear lots of hats, and I can't describe any of them to you in 20 seconds, so you don't really need to know about them right now. The ideas I'm talking about tonight are slightly newer take on the age-old organizational wrestling match between sales and marketing. Anybody know that? I'll start with a little more blatant honesty. This whole thing's really just about me. But it's America, damn it, and I'm looking out for number one. It all started when I was examining my career as a creative professional and some of the challenges of my past, present, and future, and I kind of stumbled on this notion. So let's take a look at the traditional mindset in business organization. The dreaded sales and marketing department. It all comes together at the top with a big cheese, and he has a spoon in both of those pots, or two spoons in two pots, whichever perverted analogy you want to use. At the top, of course, personal income is higher. The closer to the big cheese you get, the more money you get. And the further down the slope, you end up somewhere between what I would call the soul-eating rat race and the Eden containing the hippie-starving artists. So you can make less money and be happier with your trade, or compromise and be the boss. You can guess where I'm going. This is something I did once I had the diagram. I mapped my career through it, starting with my first retail job. You'll notice target mini-mid, which is the comfort zone where I could exist, but I would eventually have to sell out to the sales interest, or I would have a career ceiling of income where I could no longer philosophically make it work. Many times in sales, you're in a scrappy fight to bring back something nice to your master and live and die by it. Marketing professionals, especially creatives, do not thrive in this world. Continuing our canine analogy, creative and communication professionals in marketing tend to spend a lot of time thinking of ideas and how to put them out there to the consuming masses. He probably should have had that idea a long time ago. I don't think you get to see him get hurt anymore on TV. It can result in a pretty impressive operation. Sales will soar, and marketing gets to do it all while sporting a speed dude. There are exceptions to this spectacular display. Sometimes things fall flat, and marketing needs to go back to the drawing board, start thinking, re-researching, re-communicating. So neither group can do it alone. You do have to work together. Your sales pitch can be great, but if we creators don't dress it up for you, it's just another snack on the buffet. So you have to coexist. At the same time, marketing cannot get all the attention and interest. Marketing can get all the interest and attention in the world, but if we're not really there to close the deal. It's a sales job, and we should not expect to be measured in the same ways. Some people are going to be lost on that, but that's leading a horse to water. I found that this visual didn't play well the opposite. We're a business full of imagination. Anyway, it's a truly symbiotic relationship. One needs the other. The same rules can't apply to both, and this is where the traditional notions no longer apply. I tried to think something clever about watering me, so I couldn't think of the opposite. So there's a lot of media and a lot of message out there. Making use of it is not simply a numbers game, and it's not always tangible. Some of you that work in social media probably understand that. And yes, sure, you brag about hits, but you can't totally get it when it comes to what the recipient is thinking. You just have to be trusted to do so. And there are numerous changing mediums that are both blessings and curses to the modern brand. leaving people to manipulate those into growing businesses and understand them, and that can be key to the success of modern creative. So really what it all boils down to, and this is where I had my little career epiphany, aka way to make better money, it's all about freeing creative minds. Creativity and communication in the marketing operation cannot simply be held inside the same box with the same rules as the numbers-driven sales team, especially not now. So what I decided to do, I split my pyramid, which will come up whenever 20 seconds runs out. Because this next one's really long. A marketing and creative operation that can be dedicated to both bean counting of results measurement and the creation of unique insightful media. Then you have a sales operation which can chase the numbers, but also be in the loop of how it all works without having to share too many marketing roles. And executive management can be at the top, completely saturated in their respective elements. Note also, the income range persists, but the comfort zones become more evenly distributed to those in marketing. Either side can grow their career indefinitely, depending on the business and market. We achieve a cultural keystone that I like to call informed faith. Another way of saying this, it's like having a team, it's the difference between having a team of raving lunatics who have no idea what the true conditions of their market or the spirit of their brand really are, or a calm and wise uniformity of missions and teamwork. So easy to find a Westboro Baptist Church picture that looks So I'm not the only person that's noticed this and the merits. These kinds of separate and equal approaches have been adopted recently by GM. In the separation of their brands, marketing, and sales operations, and adding this to their model as they proceed on a rather high-stakes path forward. If they are willing to make a gamble on this, I think other businesses should probably give it a try and realize that marketing and sales do not always belong in the same place.
Like a 10-minute beer break, everybody.